Hello students, let us continue the lesson Respiration in Organisms. In the last class, we have learnt breathing mechanism in human beings. Now, we'll learn about breathing in other animals. Now, how do other organisms breathe? Do they have lungs like those of human beings? Let us find out. Now, you can see the picture of a cockroach on the right side. How do the cockroaches breathe? The cockroach has small openings on the sides of its body. Other insects also have similar openings. These openings are called spiracles. Insects have a network of air tubes called trachea for gas exchange. Oxygen-rich air rushes through the spiracles into the tracheal tubes and it diffuses into the body tissue and reaches every cell of the body. Similarly, carbon dioxide from the cells goes into the tracheal tubes and moves out through spiracles. These air tubes or trachea are found only in insects and not in any other group of animals. So, insects breathe through spiracles or trachea. Now, the picture, the left side, that shows the breathing in earthworm. The skin of an earthworm is very moist and slimy on touching. So, gases can easily pass through them. Though frogs have a pair of lungs like human beings, they can also breathe through their skin, which is moist and slippery. So, earthworms breathe through their moist skin. Now, we learn about breathing in fishes. Gills in fish help them to use oxygen dissolved in water. So, fish gets oxygen dissolved in water with the help of gills. Gills are the projections of the skin, as you can see in the picture. So those are the gills. How gills help in breathing? Gills are well supplied with blood vessels for exchange of gases. Now, how do plants respire? So, like other living organisms, plants also respire for their survival. They also take in oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide. In the cells, oxygen is used to break down glucose into carbon dioxide and water, as in other organisms. In plants, each part can independently take in oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide. Yes, that the leaves of the plants have tiny pores called stomata for exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. You have learned this in the lesson Nutrition in Plants. Like all other living cells of the plants, the root cells also need oxygen to generate energy. So, how do roots get oxygen? Roots take up air from the air spaces present between the soil particles. You can see in between the soil particles there is an air spaces present between the soil particles. So this is how the roots get oxygen. Yes, now in this lesson you have learned that respiration is a vital biological process. All living organisms need to respire to get the energy needed for their survival. Now, so far what have you learnt? Aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration, cellular respiration, inhalation, exhalation, breathing rate, breathing mechanism, that is diaphragm, lungs, gills, spiracles. Now, the respiratory organs in fish, that is gills, and respiratory organ in insects, spiracles or trachea, the ribs, that is the skeletal structure that supports the that cover protects the lungs. Yes, this is all about the respiration in organisms. Let us end up the class here. Thank you.